Good morning to all of you. Welcome to Legal Matters by Sai Babu Sankara. Today we are going to case where a departmental action or an employee is involved. Here the importance of the judgment is that if an employee suppresses the material facts, if an employee gives wrong information about his criminal antecedents or involvement in any crime or like that, so he is not eligible to continue in the department, because it depends on the trust of the employer. If you start giving false statements like that, so then what happens, where it will lead, all these things let us discuss. So this was enunciated in the case of Rajasthan Rajya Prasaran Nigam Limited, that is Electricity Board, Rajasthan Rajya Prasaran Nigam Limited versus Anil Kanwalia. Anil Kanwalia, 2021. This is in civil appeal number 5143 and 5144 by 2021, and the judgment is delivered very recently on 17/9/2021 by two judges bench, M.R. Shah and A.S. Bopanna. They held that if the employee who made a false statement, then or he suppressed the fact about his involvement in a criminal case, he is not entitled to continue in the department. Very simple case. So if you go into the details, it will be more beneficial for you. So this Anil Kanwalia, right, he joined in the so called Rajasthan Rajya Prasaran Nigam Limited as a class 2 employee. And then at the time of joining, this is more, at the time of admission, he gave a false affidavit, or he gave an affidavit which is later proven false, that he is not involved in any criminal case. But after verification, the Nigam Limited, they found that yes, he has given false information. Therefore, they terminated his services immediately. So he has approached the Honorable High Court of Rajasthan. So here the main point you have to note is that this man was convicted under Section 12 of the Probation of Offenders Act. Right, he was convicted, but the Probation of Offenders Act has been applied. That means he was kept under probation for 2 or 3 years. And you all know that according to Section 3 and 4 of the Probation of Offenders Act, so even though he was convicted, it should not be noted as conviction. So it is not equal to acquittal also, but it will not amount to conviction, right? So here he has not mentioned that he is involved in any case. Very serious. That means he has suppressed the material facts. Of course, that by suppressing the material facts, he has given a false information. Later, it came to light that he was involved in a case as a young boy, and later he was reprimanded or given the Probation of Offenders Act, and the PO Act has been completed. After 2 years only, he joined the department. But still, since he has suppressed the material fact, so definitely after finding, so he has suppressed the material fact, he was terminated from the services. The Honorable High Court held that. So conviction and PO Act cannot be taken as a conviction. So therefore, you have to reinstate him. You have to give all the consequential benefits, all these things the Honorable High Court has told. Reinstatement with all consequential benefits. So High Court has ordered for his reinstatement. Now, against the order of the High Court, Rajasthan Rajya Prasaran Nigam Limited, they have filed a civil appeal before the Honorable Supreme Court. So the Supreme Court noted that it is not about the conviction or acquittal, it's a different thing. But the suppression of the fact, the trust in which the department has to levy on him, if he gives such types of false statements, then where the department goes, and how can the trust be given on him? So Supreme Court says that it is not the material, whether an employee is involved in a case of trivial nature, the case is also very small nature, whether he's acquitted or not. The question is about the credibility. This is more important. Please hear. The question is about the credibility. The question is about the trustworthiness of the employee. So such an employee cannot continue because the employer will give so much of so much of trust to him, which need so much of confidence or trust in him. But how can the employer give trust to him? Definitely the employer has got the choice of terminating his services. Such an employee cannot be continued in the department even though the offense is very trivial nature. Here, please learn. To conclude, I want to tell you, here the important point is, it is not in dispute whether he is convicted or acquitted, whether PO Act has been applied on him or not. But had he mentioned that, yes, I was involved in a case and PO Act has been applied. Yes, finished, that had gone. But since he has stated that he was not involved in any criminal case and no conviction was given to him, it was taken as a very serious, and even the Supreme Court also taken it very seriously. So very good case, particularly for the governments, it is a very good case. So please read the judgment, and if necessary, you can incorporate in one of your defenses. Thank you very much.